Amber Diaz right now. She's live at Palm Beach Election Headquarters with the latest there. Amber?
Well, Elliot, good evening to you. 5,950 ballots. That's the amount they need to recount this evening. You can take a look behind me. They already started the recount process. Supervisor of Elections says they need to finish the recount tonight before they can even start the hand recount tomorrow morning.
Right now, we're incomplete.
After hours of waiting to start a hand recount, the Palm Beach election supervisor reveals they're picking up where they left off.
We have not completed our tabulation process to come up with all of our vote totals for the U.S. Senate race and to find all of our over and under votes.
The decision made late after Palm Beach County failed to meet the machine recount deadline.
I gave the okay and I'm in charge.
The supervisor giving a number of reasons after admitting defeat.
And we're incomplete for various reasons, mostly because there were requirements that we show some duplicated damage ballots, and we haven't run those, and requirements that we canvass ballots for over and under votes that were duplicated by staff. And so we've completed that process, but now we have to go run them through our tabulators and find the rest of our over and unders.
The supervisor also blamed the machines that ran 24/7 and overheated. With those machines now up and running, they plan to work overnight to get the job done. Under law, if they were not able to finish the machine recount, they would have to stick with the count they submitted on Saturday before the recount.
I've consulted with Judge Bonavita and Erwin Jacobowitz, who are my canvassing board member partners, and I think we have consensus that we need to complete our job.
In addition to the Senate race, the supervisor of elections estimates they'll have to recount by hand at least two more races, the House District 89 and Commissioner of Agriculture.
Now back out here live in Palm Beach County, you can see these guys are still working. They'll be working well into the night. They are scheduled to start the hand recount at 11 a.m. Reporting live, Amber Diaz, CBS 4 News, tonight.
Amber, thank you. And we'll have crews watching this all night. For the latest, get the free CBS 4 News app. It's easy to find. Just go to your app store and search for CBS Local. Once you download that, scroll down and click on Miami.